I've been here and I've had 13 bras.
You've had 13 bras?
I've had 13 on.
13 on,
I've
yes.
I've got none.
Yep.
Too tight, too high. One pair I bought, I got in my car another day. Unzipped to drive home.
Oh no, that's horrendous!
They always make everything so tight that it hurts.
It shouldn't be that tight, okay?
You
shouldn't be able to feel your bra on. That is the key to a good fitting bra. There are some rules to watch. The back part here, you know, the strap that goes across the back, that should sit at a horizontal line. Completely horizontal. It shouldn't be riding up, it shouldn't be riding down. You should also be able to put two fingers underneath each strap, okay? That's another mistake that a lot of people make, in that they do these up so tight because they think, right, we're going to hoik them up by doing, yeah, we've all done it, I know. But that's actually, you've got the wrong size bra on if you're trying to hoik it up and it's, you know, it's digging into your shoulder. By the end of the day, you've got these big crevices like the Grand Canyon from, you know, holding them up all day. So there are a lot of things like that. A good bra fitter should be able to take you through the process. If you are not feeling comfortable in it, do not buy it, because you should not be able to feel the bra on. Shona, what sort of things can we do?
That's just what we've been talking about, you know, our favourite little basic here, and then you throw on the scarf when you're doing the kid run. Where's our little... scarves, jewellery, dramatic jewellery, scarves. So you keep your black basics and you just throw on something before you walk out the door, and it just gives you a psychological boost, like the lovely pink scarf. You suddenly look refreshed and updated. Or that tribal necklace. Did we give someone that tribal? We've
yes,
done that, the tribal necklace, which is lovely and dramatic, not expensive. So you keep your basic outfit flattering to your figure. That's why
I
love the tunics.
Find something that makes you feel good in it, you know, a really great cut pair of jeans that should suit your shape, or a really nice pair of cargo pants or something, because I understand that you've got to be able to move and do all of that sort of thing. And find some things that are flattering you that way, and then just keep revolving them around and add some accessories into it, and that will cut your time down, because you're not going to be thinking about what the foundations are going to be. You're going to say, right, I'll put my jeans on with that top that I've got.
So rather than doing that top which stops here, what you need is a tunic to here, whatever colour, and black's fine, black's absolutely fine for here, and then team it with a cropped jacket so you get the double hemline, so you've not got bulk and bulk, heavy all around here. You do one hemline to here to cover hips and thighs, and then you team it with a shorter jacket here.
Again, creating that story. Well, thank you, Shona. Shona will be around. The foundation I've used is Photo Ready Foundation from Revlon, which is also light reflective, and it works with any light that you go into. And should you happen to get your photograph taken, because everybody's snap happy now because everybody's phone's got cameras on it, and then you end up on Facebook looking pale faced because the flash.
And then
can
you say, oh, it's that person's camera that's wrong. Yeah. No, I don't look like
but then
that.
You start thinking, is my foundation too pale? But what it does, it reacts to the flash. But this particular foundation does not. It actually is really flattering. It's a dewy look, it's not a matte look, and it will work with any light that you go into and any flash photography.
So the one question that so many women ask me is, how do I get my foundation to sit right and look nice? How many of you have that problem? And that is the number one question people say, my foundation just doesn't look great. There is a secret to getting a good looking foundation, and it's all in the preparation. So we've got a secret to getting that flawless finish, and that is a primer. This sort of tube size will last you 6 months or more. You need the smallest amount, so you don't want to overuse your primer. So you moisturise as normal, and then you put your primer on top, and it just glides over. So if you think of it of sealing in your moisturiser underneath, and then giving a smooth finish for your foundation to glide on top of. You find the open pores, you won't have the makeup sitting there, and in the little crease lines, you know, those expression lines that we all have, you find that your makeup during the day won't tend to move and sit and collect there. So your makeup will stay on a lot longer.
Little Angelina Jolie tip.
If you want to make your lips look a bit fuller, because we all like curly lips, but we're not going to stick Restylane in them, unless you're Amy, and that's another story, and we'll get to that in a minute. Put a little bit of clear gloss in the middle of your lips, on both right down here, and then right at the top after you've put your lipstick on, and that's going to pick up the light and going to make your lips look fuller. So you can all try that little one at home.
Basic kind of rule in terms of blending eyeshadows?
Well, the beauty of those quads or trios is that they're all perfectly matched together to work in harmony to create a beautiful eye. And first of all, you want to start with the lightest colour all over the lid and up to the crease, and that's normally a sort of a champagne-y colour or a white colour. That's your base highlighter. Then you'll use the middle one to go all over your lid to give you the colour. And then you use the darkest one as a liner and in your crease to give yourself a bit of definition.
Well, with bronzer, you need a big, soft, round brush is the best thing to use. And the idea with bronzer is to not to colour your whole face in, but to apply it where the sun would naturally hit it. And you can also use bronzer or a dark powder to create a little bit of contour, which what we were talking about before. Give yourself the illusion of some cheekbones and
Who has the double chin problem? Pretty much most of us do, especially when we see, again, photographs. We're going to be fine if we've got photo-ready foundation on, but then we all of a sudden go, I don't have that double chin. Where did that come from? You can use some bronzer to make some areas disappear. Again, we're trying to trick people. How does that work?
Exactly. So you've got to be light-handed, don't go too heavy-handed, but basically if you apply bronzer just behind your chin and around here, it's going to give the illusion that your chin's coming back, so you
it's disappearing
that double chin.
You can also use that trick if you've got a slightly larger nose or you've got a slightly rounder face. You can use it to contour
dark colors will recede.
Yeah, but that's something that you want to practice as well. Who has their eyebrows shaped? Who goes and has it professionally shaped? Well done. It's one of the cheapest beauty treatments out there that will make the biggest difference. You know, a $15 eyebrow shape is a lot cheaper than a $7,000 facelift. But pretty much you're doing the same thing. Now, what about if you were a little overzealous with your plucking earlier on? Amy's had everything done, by the way. She's a bit like an exhibit in the zoo.
Well, I have actually had my eyebrows tattooed on. So it's a fantastic...
And everyone goes,
fantastic. You can come and have a look at me later if you like. But it's the best thing I ever did. Don't have to pencil or powder them on every day. But if you aren't as game as me to try all that sort of extreme stuff, using a liner or a powder brush is a perfect way to create a beautiful brow, but you must remember to keep the line soft. A harsh line is aging and it just does not look right. If you use a liner, you want to use the pencil and then
the little brush on
the little brush to soften it.
Just tell us how that works.
And with this, it's a soft crayon, soft little strokes through the eyebrow, turn it round, brush it through. So it ends up looking like little soft brush strokes rather than a hard line. And it's amazing how many women do beautiful eye makeup and then they don't touch their eyebrows and it looks unfinished because they actually frame your eyes and it makes such a difference.
Let's just talk about the one thing that you should do, and I understand there's mothers and that you don't have time and you don't want to put this on. I don't think anybody should leave the house without dressing their lashes. I think if you're going to use one beauty product, do mascara. Yeah. Absolutely, makes such a difference. Who knows how to put on mascara correctly?
We should use a little shimmy technique, and Revlon have a fantastic new mascara, Grow Luscious, which not only gives you beautiful lashes, but it conditions your lashes, just like we condition our hair.
But when we say shimmy, it's a movement like that. And what it does is it grabs the lashes and works them through the wand as you go up. So you get a much stronger coating of mascara rather than that. And you should always do your bottom lashes first. Because when you're looking in a mirror, if you do your top lashes and then you go to do the bottom, you look like that, and all the bits of black coated your lashes end up here.
And then you got to get a cotton bud out and put it all on. And